ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. سبحانك لا نحصي ثناءً عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله على ما أنعمت وأوليت يا رب العالمين. اللهم كما أنعمت فأدم وزدنا من نعمك واجعلنا من الشاكرين. اللهم عرفنا نعمك بدوامها ولا تعرفنا نعمك بزوالها. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليل أرسله رحمة للعالمين وهدى وبشرى للمحسنين. وصل اللهم عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه واتبع سنته واقتفى أثره بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فيقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز: فبما رحمة من الله لنت لهم ولو كنت فظا غليظ القلب لانفضوا من حولك فاعف عنهم واستغفر لهم وشاورهم في الأمر. وروى الإمام مسلم في صحيحه عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها أنها قالت: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الرفق لم يكن في شيء إلا زانة، ولم يرفع من شيء إلا شانة. Allah the Almighty says in the Quran: by the grace of Allah, you were gentle and kind with them, referring to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Had you been harsh and hard-hearted, they would have dispersed from around you. So forgive them, pardon them, and seek forgive them for them, and consult them in matters. In Sahih Muslim, Aisha narrated radiallahu anha that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, gentleness or kindness never exists in anything but beautifies it, and never taken out from anything but damages it. As it's Rabi' al-Awwal, we tend to talk more about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it's not an exclusive property for Rabi' al-Awwal to talk about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but because it's closer to the people's heart on that very special month of his birth alayhi salatu wasallam. So the overarching ayah in the Quran: قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. Say, if you really love Allah, follow me, i.e. the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah will love you. So the true love is about following, true ittiba', if you want. So I'll be addressing today one of his characters alayhi salatu wasalam: kindness and gentleness, rifq. So he was so kind, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we need to follow his footsteps and to be kind. Whoever has been given gentleness and kindness has been given goodness, as in Sahih Muslim as well. من أعطي الرفق فقد أعطي الخير ومن حرم من الرفق فقد حرم من الخير. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُعْطِي عَلَى الرِّفْقِ مَا لَا يُعْطِي عَلَى الْعُنْفِ. As well in Sahih Muslim, Allah will reward for gentleness and kindness what He will never reward for harshness. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was gentle, was nice, was kind, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And in the hadith as well: إن الله رفيق يحب الرفق. Allah is kind. He loves kindness. So Allah is kind and he encourages kindness and he loves kindness, how to be kind. A young man, as it's been narrated in Musnad Ahmad, Yusanad in Sahih, very sound narration. A young man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulallah, i'zan li bizzina. فأخذ أصحابه يزجرونه ويقولون له مه مه. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم أدن مني. قال فدنا فجلس. فقال أترضاه لأمك؟ قال بأبي أنت وأمي يا رسول الله. لا. قال وكذلك الناس لا يرضونه لأمهاتهم. قال أترضاه لابنتك؟ قال بأبي أنت يا رسول وأمي يا رسول الله. لا. قال فكذلك الناس لا يرضونه لبناتهم. أترضاه لأختك؟ قال لا. قال فكذلك الناس لا يرضونه لأخواتهم. قال أترضاه لعمتك؟ قال لا. قال فكذلك الناس لا يرضونه لعماتهم. أترضاه لخالتك؟ قال لا. قال فكذلك الناس لا يرضونه لخالاتهم. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم فوضع يده على الشاب، وربما وضعها على صدره أو على رأسه، لم يحدد الراوي، فقال اللهم اغفر ذنبه واهد قلبه وحسن فرجه. قال فلم يعد لمثلها أبدا، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. In that very narration, a young man came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and he said, يا رسول الله, give me the permission for adultery. And then the companions were mad, started shouting at him, saying, how dare you? Shush, shush. And then the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, come closer, come closer. Then he came closer to the Prophet. He sat down. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, with his gentleness, with his kindness, he said, do you accept this on your mother? He said, no. He said, exactly the same, people will not accept it for their mothers. Do you accept this for your daughter? He said, no. He said, exactly the same, people will not accept it for their daughters. Do you accept this for your sister? He said, no. He said, exactly, people do not like this for their sisters. Do you accept this for your paternal aunt? He said, no. He said, exactly, people do not accept it for the paternal aunts. Do you accept this for maternal aunts? He said, no. He said, exactly, people do not like this for maternal aunts. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam put his hand on the young man and he made this beautiful dua. He said, oh Allah, forgive his sin, guide his heart and protect his chastity. And it says that that very man, he has no inclination anymore to any sinful act afterwards. Alayka salatu wassalam ya Rasulallah. Imagine this in our community. The people would have beaten him up in the mosque. With his gentleness, he delivered the message with his kindness, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He knew that he's a young man, full of energy, and he's still single, and he wants to marry, but he doesn't know how to do that. So quickest way is zina. So, but with his pure heart, he wants to get the permission. He doesn't want to do something wrong, by the way. By approaching the Prophet, it shows you that he has a good heart. He's not into the sin for the sin itself, or for disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal. No, he wants to do it with obedience, if you want. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood the concerns of that young man, and he treated him with gentleness, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Had he treated him in a different way, that very man could have done zina and went through all sorts of sinful acts. But he understood from the prophetic approach, come closer. So he looked after him, one to one, the proximity of the Prophet ﷺ to him. It's a very important way of tarbiyah. And then he started going through the list of his close people to his heart. His mother, his daughter, his sister, his paternal and maternal aunts. And he understood that he went through the logic, not just through the feeling. So logic and feeling together, heart and mind together. And this is his kindness, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So his delivery was the best delivery. His way of teaching was the best way of teaching. So we can understand more the hadith where he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُعْطِي عَلَى الرِّفْقِ مَا لَا يُعْطِي عَلَى الْعُنْفِ. Allah rewards for gentleness what he doesn't reward for anything else. And you see the reward here. And he finished that very conversation with practical solutions. He made his dua, alayhi salatu wasalam. And you can see that he did not reprimand him. He did not say, how dare you? He did not shout at him. He did not meet him with a frowning face. He met him with his kindness and gentleness, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is how we should teach our children and our community, alayhi salatu wasalam. In another example, Muawiyah ibn al-Hakam al-Sulami, one of the companions. It's been narrated in Sahih Imam Muslim. He says, I was praying with a companion and somebody sneezed. فَعَطَسَ أَحَدُهُمْ فَقُلْتُ يَرْحَمُكَ اللَّهُ. So he was during his salah, somebody sneezed. Then Muawiyah ibn al-Hakam al-Sulami said, يَرْحَمُكَ اللَّهُ. And then the companions were staring at me. They said nothing, but they stared at me. And I said, what's wrong with you? وَأَثَكْلَ أُمَّيَّا. So he made the special expression the Arab usually say in such scenario. What's wrong with you? Why you are looking at me like that? فَأَخَذُوا يَضْرِبُونَ عَلَىٰ أَفْخَاذِهِمْ. So they started hitting the thighs. And then he understood that they are trying to stop me from speaking. So I didn't say anything, I just stopped speaking. And then when the Prophet ﷺ finished his salah, he approached me. فَوَاللَّهِ مَا نَهَرَنِي وَلَا كَهَرَنِي وَلَا شَتَمَنِي. So by Allah, he did not reprimand me. He did not face me with a frowning face. He did not insult me. But rather he said, إِنَّ هَذِهِ الصَّلَاةِ لَا يَصْلُحُ فِيهَا شَيْءٌ مِّن كَلَامِ النَّاسِ إِنَّمَا هِيَ التَّسْبِيحُ وَالتَّكْبِيرُ وَقِرَاءَةُ الْقُرْآنِ. So our salah is a form of ibadah. Nothing of people's talks can be involved in this salah. It's all about tasbih, takbir, and recitation of the Quran. And the companion commented on that. He said he is the best teacher, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his kindness. Now, some of you might wonder, how come he doesn't know that he shouldn't speak during the salah? He was a new Muslim. And in the very beginning, it was allowed for them to speak during the salah. So he didn't know that there's an ayah was revealed to abrogate this. And that very ayah was حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الْوُسْطَى وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. Preserve your prayers and the middle prayer, and stand up in your prayer with attentiveness. And qanidin, attentiveness here, it prevented any talks during the salah but tasbih and takbir and qira'at al-Qur'an. So he has no idea that this was revealed. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with his kindness, approached that very companion and taught him. So we need to follow his footsteps, alayhi salatu wasalam. When we have some problems, and we all have problems, we need to approach our problems with kindness and gentleness and rifq, rather than harshness and frowning faces and shouting and screaming. This wasn't a prophetic character. The prophetic character was a gentle character, a kind character, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, for us, it's a practical lesson. We need not only to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam theoretically, but we need to love him through our practice, by following his footsteps, by following his character, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I ask Allah azza wa jal to enable us to follow his footsteps, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and be among those who are kind and nice. Ameen. Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa salatu wa salamu ala al-Nabi wa Mustafa wa alihi wa sahbihi wa man bi ahlihi wa fa. As usual, in every Rabi' al-Awwal, we have circulation of viral social media posts, messages, and what have you. And one of these very common things, which I have to warn you against, there's a very famous so-called hadith that Allah says, لَوْلَاكَ لَوْلَاكَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ لَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْأَفْلَاكَ. And this is a very famous statement. If it wasn't for you, O Muhammad, I would have never created the creation. And this in circulation, that this is a hadith, and the holy hadith, Allah is addressing the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Unfortunately, this is a fabricated hadith. The top critics of hadith mention this, like Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, Ibn al-Jawzi, Mullah Ali al-Qari, and it's a long list of top critics in hadith. So we need to be careful not to circulate this and not to believe in this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam has been elevated by Allah Azza wa Jal. His status already elevated by Allah. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرًا. Allah elevated his status. No need for fabrication to elevate his status, alayhi salatu wasalam. And the other circulation as well is about إِنَّ أَوَّلَ مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهِ نُورَ نَبِيِّكَ يَا جَابِرٍ. The first thing that Allah has created is the light of your Prophet, O Jabir. Again, this is another fabricated hadith. So we cannot circulate this. This is an amana. So be careful not to forward any hadith like that. We need to double check and get into the sources of hadith. Not any book, not any post. The sources of hadith, as you get the ayah from the Quran, you get the hadith from the sources of hadith. And this is amana. Knowledge is amana. So we need to be careful not to circulate hadith which is not authentic. Especially if it's related to the status of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Double check and be careful. And this is not in any shape or form degrading the status of the Prophet. Hasha. No, at all. It's elevating the status of the Prophet when we narrate the correct sound narrations on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In Sahih Muslim as well and Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man qala alayya ma lam aqul, falyatabawwa maq'adahu min an-nar." Whoever attributed something to me which I never said, let him find his dwell in hellfire. So it's not a joke. It's a serious matter. So we need to be very careful. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and protect his authentic sunnah and be amongst those who follow it and apply it in our life. Ameen. Allahumma ya Rabbu ya Rahman. Ya Badi'a as-samawati wal ardi. Ya Dhal Jalali wal Ikram. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afwa wal afiyah wal mu'afat al-da'im. بالدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم أكرمنا باتباع نبيك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم ارزقنا الرفق يا رب العالمين واجعلنا من عبادك الذين يتبعون أحسن القول يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك يا الله أن تغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا ولأصحاب الحقوق علينا. اللهم ثبتنا على الحق وانصرنا بالحق يا رب العالمين. اللهم أحينا مسلمين وأمتنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين واجمعنا بسيد المرسلين صلى الله عليه وسلم واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم يا رب يا رحمن يا بديع السماوات والأرض يا ذا الجلال والإكرام فرج عن أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم انصر عبادك المستضعفين. اللهم انتصر للمظلومين. اللهم عليك بالظالمين فإنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا ولأصحاب الحقوق علينا. صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. أجب دعانا بكرمك يا مولانا والحمد لله رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر. الله يعلم ما تصنعون. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.